We come from a farm, from a big, small African country, but we feel that we are in the home of fraternity, work, progress, which in itself makes us feel thankful for the great hospitality we were here, as well as feeling honored with the invitation we received to participate of this good opportunity to share our experiences and expectations regarding each one of our political organizations and respective countries. The Jean Jaurès Foundation reminds us of the ideas and work of the Lucius Sutor, the socialist of deep convictions and of notorious political ability that was murdered in July 31st of 1913, making his own time on a difficult period of the labor movements in Europe. Coordinator of this government, the European Foundation of Progressive Studies, think tank of experts that conducts research and produce concealing of the utmost importance for political and economical issues, thus being an extremely useful academy for our work. The PNDS, member of the International Socialists, which besides having strengthened democracy in the country with this experience, is giving a major contribution to the political and social development of Niger through this very event. Ladies and gentlemen, the theme of this meeting, elections, democracy and good and governance in West and Central Africa, interpellates our organizations to conduct a deep reflection, upon issues in several iterations for the enunciation of a progressive path to our countries. As we formulate our respective global policies that will respond to the expectations of our populations regarding economic well-being and social peace, the foundation of our democracy. In its secular existence and cycle of experience, democracy is always an instrument in permanent experimentation, resulting of its necessary and continuous effective through invariable social and political dynamics that citizens and respective societies goes to the one carrying the political responsibilities. In Niger, Cabo Verde, Senegal, Chad, Equatorial Guinea, Central African Republic, Congo, Brazzaville, Gabon, Democratic Republic of Congo, Cameroon, France, Tunis, Mali, Burkina Faso, among so many other countries, we converge in the need for our people to be assured the effective exercise of civil citizenship with full democratic participation of the citizens and the consequent benefit to the development generated from it. And it is true that each one of our countries has experienced distinct facts through the nature of historical conditions determined by secular economic, social, and political dynamics which characterize different political identities in the common perception of democracy. On the other hand, we must take into account the growing globalization that comes with economic and financial crises, which are, first off, given the factors of debt and financial lack of regulation, tying the dependency which ordinance most of the time is out of our reach. The world today is interconnected by policies of a non-advanced economy that intending to impose a so-called globalization of democracy will not understand the internal balance of Africa with its own web policies, many times suggested by the main donor countries to establish a close relation between the donation and democratization, conditioning in this form the implementation of public policies and of a plural political practice with severe consequences in terms of unemployment, lack of hope, and discouragement of thousands of people, especially our youth. Actually, the injustice of this orthodoxy in the international economic affairs does not contribute to a cooperation based on an interculturality of cooperation in the field of our commercial exchange. Ladies and gentlemen, many will be the factors determining the democracy with which each one of us will intend himself in our countries. Besides the fact that this concept is regarded as a way of government and organization of a state, let us keep in mind that it is a way of social organization where all the citizens are free and equal, and in which social relations are established according to contractual mechanisms. This to say that in each society, being in a customary way or not, from a perception of participation, formulates consequently a certain way of understanding and exercise democracy. Let us take as example the democracy in the United States of America, which obeys the very most references of conception of democracy and citizenship by the full American citizen since the founding of their nation. Let us look at the constitutional European system, each one owing to reasons founded through the historical facts. Look at the Asian systems, whose references are tied to millenarian cultural roots as strongholds of political and social cohesion of those countries. And let us look at last to our continent, Africa, in which the model of the political system and social and economic development has a lot to do with the whole colonial powers. Ladies, gentlemen, participants, we think that the exercise of democracy and consequently of citizenship is not an orthodox goal either to the resulting and determining cultural reality, which will not be attained if there is no affirmation of the cognitive and dialogical complementarities respecting and valuing the virtues and the capabilities of the physical, geographical, and human reality of each country and nation. We mean by saying this that democracy, elections, and good governance can only be a reality if the premise mentioned in both actually exist, so that they also ensure the belief in politics, the trust in democracy, the sense of belonging to the society, and the perspective of the future. We believe that in our countries there are barriers that can only be surpassed through the knowledge of our own reality, through a process politically promised as a shared objective among all, to make room to union and consequently to the cohesion of the national dimension. This brief reflection means that we are all committed to the same causes, and that even within our differences, we should find synergies to settle democracy. Regarding Cabo Verde, my country, we must, first of all, take into account that we are a small country with a population of about 500,000 and whose only reserves are its own citizens, the Cape Verdean woman and the Cape Verdean man. A small country, but nevertheless a giant in his ambition to create a new land within his land, of conquering a new future for its people with more equality, more opportunities, and more prosperity to all. This country, on which I am proud up to the deepest of my soul, has come a long way since its independence, 41 years ago, a way to doubt and action based on historical reality, past and present, always with the futurist perspective, having experienced disadvantage, and obligation. Since a little stage on the 5th of July of 1975, the Independence Day, following the teachings of the great thinker of the freedom fights in Africa, Amilcar Cabral, the issue of democracy was made present. In order to reach the necessary maturity to demonstrate regulation, foundations and formal mechanisms of the independent state had to be built, and uncertainties and resistances as to the viability of Cabo Verde as an independent country had to be faced. The good governance was a strategic path adopted from this early stage to ensure a good management of the great sums invested, highlighting the fact that the covert application of the public health for development at the time allowed strong investments in health, forestation, mobilization in agric resources, as well as education. A strong investment in the democratization of better education. This effort resulted in an evolution to new dimensions of citizenship, meaning the evolution of citizenship in the legal, political, and social scope. The understanding of the developments and transformations that education produced in society, and at the same time, the analysis of the signs of a new era at the global level, led to the end of the one-party system by PACV, which announced a new phase of the exercise of citizenship and the opening for a multi-party system in which the exercise of citizenship through elections contributed to public wellness. In the dynamic process of a political and social transition, citizenship reached a mature state and the ability for the exercise of democratic political power through the election process. So in January 1991, after the logistics, institutional and legal conditions were created by PACV, the first democratic elections in the country took place. The PACV, even though having acted as a protagonist in this process, lost the election. We lost to the emerging political party after 50 years of political exercise. But we accept, we respect, and we contribute to the development of our country. After this, a new experience took place in the following 10 years, which allowed us to better know our new social cultural reality under the new global phase, thus formulating the ways of doing politics in the face of new relevant factors. It was a period of first opposition, critical and rough, in which we retried our political capital so that in 2001 the voters became voters who renewed their trust in PICP for 3 consecutive mandates of a governance that produced profound social, economic, and political transformation in the Cape Verdean society. I had the honor to be part of this process as Minister of President of Council of Ministers from Youth, Work, Employment, Family, and Development of Human Resources during 8 years in the government of Cape Verde. A time of positive march to good governance that is highlighted by Cabo Verde's graduation to the level of country of medium development, as recognized by the United Nations in 2008. However, in 2016, on the Jesuit elections, the voters choose our opponent to govern the country. Could it be that this happened due to the so-called political cycle phenomenon? Did we not incur in the necessary political pedagogy regarding the new perception that resulted from the social dynamics? The results were unexpected, given the high expectations generation by the dimension and quality of the development attained, which on one hand gave room to multiple questioning in the party, my party, PACV, as well as the need for new internal elections of the managing bodies of PACV, aiming its renovation and new political directives aligned with the new responses by the society in the new era. We question ourselves, learning with our mistakes and forcing ourselves to adjustments and our historical experience, practicing a new proximity to the population and the development of a new quality of democracy and citizenship. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to be optimist and stating that democracy, in fact, is possible. But as we mentioned before, it is a process in constant progress and regeneration. It is not, by any means, a finished product, but a constant exercise of citizenship. We must know ourselves best, better. We must know deepest our reality with its own specific vulnerabilities, universal and true, so that as partner we may fully comprehend the plurality and strength of our differences, to share our common points, and through dialogue and cooperation, position ourselves at the same level of our responsibilities in the present, in the future, in Africa, and in the world. With recyclable availability, we are all are for an alliance of generous principles and values, the characteristics of the progress society of Africa and humanity, where we have a world of peace to bring to a dialogue, economic stability, and social equality. We have an important role to play in this world marked by crises and conflicts, regarding cooperative diversity without arrogance or superiority. Once more, I address the organizers for this happy opportunity of a healthy confrontation